Good morning, folks. Well, Diego here. It's only 1:45 in the morning on a Monday morning, May 15th, 2023. The next morning, we have to go to work after Mother's Day weekend, and I'm over here in San Quintin, Mexico, staying at the Rio del Cora Hotel. San Quintin is just a one highway town that goes from north to south, south to north. Okay. And it's real quiet over here at almost 2 a.m. I went to bed early, couldn't sleep anymore. Just got up to check on my truck. It's doing pretty good over here. Right here by the office. I couldn't take it under the hotel parking lot entrance. Yeah, we tried to take it under there to go to the back and couldn't do it. So, just out here enjoying the peace and quiet of the early Monday morning. This place is full of farm workers and truck drivers, and they get up early. Not quite this early, but they'll be getting up here pretty soon, going to school. But so peaceful over here. I just had to show you what it's like. And tomorrow, hopefully, we'll find some fishing buddies, some connections to go fishing here in San Quintin. Okay. Only thing I miss, I get lonely when I'm on the road and no company. But I don't miss the little woman when she's being bad and not helping me. So, we'll see how it goes, folks. Take care. God bless. Okay, good morning, people. It's Monday morning, pretty early, 6:30 or so. And waking up here in San Quintin, Mexico. It's a beautiful sunrise, kind of overcasty though. And guess what? I'm going to be heading home, back to Tijuana, okay? No bug out plan for today. I got to get home and pay the bills and help out and talk about everything that's going on. So the bug out plan has to be put on hold for now. I got work to do. It's a long, hard drive, 5, 6, maybe 7 hours, and bad traffic too. Okay, let me get out of here. The boat should be okay. The boat's been riding good. It's ever since I left Vegas, it's been pretty stable. Okay. Look, there's a military base called the 67th Infantry right here. So, no U-turn. Okay. Gonna go up to the next one to make a U-turn. But that's what's going on, folks. And hopefully I'll have a good, safe trip. But no plans right now for putting the boat in the water and doing the bug out plan. Okay. Talk to you later. I need some coffee. Okay, folks, it's still pretty early. I'm only like 10 miles down the road towards Tijuana. Getting some breakfast. I like the burritos. They're all ready to go, listo. bus being handicapped mall, I don't have to get out of the truck and go to the store and buy whatever. I just pull up next to the roadside little vendors. Okay. I just had to show you how they gave me the burritos. Huevos and frijoles, eggs and beans. But the little chili, the chilitos. Chilitos? Say chilitos. It's cute how they, these are really hot. But they just expect you to take a bite. Take a bite of the chili and take a bite of the burrito. I don't know if I can handle that. It's pretty hot. But anyway, that's how I like it, folks. Okay. Didn't even have to get out of the car. Cost me about, I don't know, $5 for all this. Okay. Thank you, God. I had to stop and get another different kind of burrito with some chocolate. Chocolate de abuelito, grandma's hot chocolate. Because my coffee was way too sweet. It was so sweet, I was gonna probably have a diabetic attack or something. It was so bad. Okay, and then I got the rojo chili instead of the habanero. Okay, now I'm doing good. All right. Thank you, God, for everything. The road here. Okay, folks. It's a beautiful morning, but there's lots of traffic. It's a pretty dangerous two-lane highway. So there's no room for error. But I'm trying to eat this delicious burrito. The potato and meat, carne con papas, is más mejor than the huevo and jamón. The second lady had the best burritos, meat and potatoes. And she also had hot chocolate de grandma. So that's better than the first one. The coffee was way too sweet. But that's going to be my third burrito, so I'm full now. Okay, doing good. Just got to concentrate on driving safe. Pretty sparse scenery as far as simple houses out there. Everybody's going to work already on a Monday morning. The bus is taking people to work in the fields. Some field workers are already out there before 7 o'clock in the morning. This is one of my favorite candy stores out here, the Dulceria. It's a big one, like a warehouse full of candy. Okay, and all these little colonials, they call them. The whole valley is called like the San Quintin Valley. And then it's full of these little colonials. Vicente Guerrero, Punto Colonet, Zapato Amelia, or Amelia Zapato. Okay. One of these days I'll understand their whole system. They're naming these little pueblos. It'd be interesting to see how they appear on a map. Mapa. Okay, folks, let's finish eating. So good. So good. Okay, folks, I've made it about 100 kilometers north of San Quintin, which is about halfway back to Ensenada at 100 kilometers, and it's 200 kilometers over to San Quintin from Ensenada. So making good time here. It's a beautiful morning, no wind. stopping here at the Pemex halfway between, but I've got some ropes coming loose on the boat. Hasn't been doing too bad. My parking lights are on, which are working good. Okay, this one here is, this is loose. I gotta retie this. Okay. The main ropes so are up there in the front to the H-beam spine. Everything back here looks pretty darn good. Okay. Not too bad, not too bad. Okay. Okay, the lights are working here, but this thing has to be reattached. I got duct tape holding it in because the two set bolts came out. Okay, this one's not bad, but the boat is shifted to this side. See, shifted over here. Okay. It's not bad, not bad. All the other truckers are over here. Okay. Looks pretty good. I'll just retie the main ropes. It's not too bad. Okay, folks, take one last look at the beautiful scenery over here. This is the 100 kilometer mark between San Quintin and Ensenada. Those are the Sierra Madre Mountains, the San Pedro or something like that, they call it. Dr. Stromford, my ex-wife's father, used to bring us up here to go camping back in the day. Okay, let's get these ropes tied. The tires look good. All right. Okay, folks, it's still Monday morning, the 15th of May, 2023. We're making our way back to Ensenada from San Quintin. And we're a little bit more than halfway back. I just wanted to show you this solar panel array going into a vineyard over here. On the way down, I told you about it, but I didn't show you. And this is good solar country out here. A lot of exposure to the sun and stuff. You know, middle of nowhere, there's no power lines. I like it. You know, it's like the way of the future. Let's go solar. Okay, see the vineyard? Out here, just south of Ensenada, 30, 40 miles, and it's very beautiful, but you got to get water to the grapes, to the crops, and the solar-powered well is an ideal situation. Okay. I remember this place. Then there's little Nepali farms up on the hill too, where they raise the cactus, the beaver tail cactus for the Nepalis. Okay. It's up here, coming up here. When I like something, I want to video it. Back there was a man plowing with a horse-drawn plow. Still going in this day and age, 2023. A horse-drawn plow. Man was out there in the field with one horse plowing in between the rows of his crops. Okay, now I just want to show you, we go from a horse-drawn plow
to a solar powered well pump out here. Just the difference, technology, time and technology. Okay, this guy here's, I gotta be, use caution right here, wide load with a semi coming, don't try to pass. But this is also, I think, where my solar panels were, right up here. Just beautiful out here, the hill, the foothills and the mountains of Ensenada, south of Ensenada. Okay, maybe I missed the solar panels. Okay, well, let's just try to get around this guy right here. He's hauling a disc. Okay. Yeah, I must have missed the, I'm pretty sure it was right back there. Okay. Well, folks, we made it back to Ensenada. Beautiful Ensenada. Yeah, really, it's really beautiful over here with the sewer flooding in the streets and all the traffic. It stinks too. That's pure sewer water. That's puro sewer. Ugh. Well, muy feo. Welcome to Ensenada, where the sewer flows into the ocean. Yeah, where the sewer flows into the ocean. Beautiful Ensenada. Look at this crapola. Here we go. I'm going down the street with sewer water flowing into the ocean. Oh boy. Ensenada should be really proud. Look at this. Look at this, folks. Pure sewer water flowing into the ocean. Ensenada sucks. They should be real proud of themselves for letting their sewer flow into the ocean. Untreated. Stinks. I'm having a bad day. It's no wonder Ensenada Harbor or beach. You know? I never have liked Ensenada Beach. It's dirty. And now I know why. Sewer water flows right into the bay. Hello, folks. Okay, we're downtown Ensenada. Made it back to the rat race. Yes, I would say Ensenada is the rat race. It's kind of the final destination for the tourists. Once you get south of Ensenada, it becomes more and more sparsely populated down there, and it's not so touristico. Okay, we're back in the rat race. I'm headed over there to Alfonso's. Looks like a couple of my buddies are over there, at least one, having breakfast. So I guess we'll get some coffee and think about it. My dad used to say, I'll have a cigarette and think about it. But for me, it's coffee. Okay, folks. Kind of a bad start this morning. I had to come back from my bug out plan in San Quintin. The little woman and her sons are having problems and they need me, I guess. You know, one thing that bugs me is people that want to have everything perfect, but they want to have somebody else pay for it. Okay? That doesn't work. No. You work for your own shit in this world, you know. You make your own life. If you want something nice, then you've got to work for it. That's all I can say. Okay, let's see who's over here at Alfonso's today. If I can find parking. If I can find parking. Okay. This sucks. This sucks. The parking situation sucks over here. Okay. There we go. Okay. Let's get parked. Okay. Looks like, shoot. How come I can never remember his name? It's like Enrique or something. It's a name. Damn it. He's got a short name too, a short nickname for Rafael. How come I can never remember Rafael? Rafa, one of the Ninja Turtles. Okay. I got to think of the Ninja Turtles. All right. He's a really smart guy though.